I want to keep this video very short. It's all about the IF amplifier that I've published earlier. And here you see it again. Consisting of four, say, more or less single resonance filters of 455 kilocycles, but made in such a configuration that you can use it as an IF filter with a bandwidth of approximately 10 kilocycles. Here is the first schematic. There's a separate video and everything is told in that video. Here is the second schematic yesterday or so. And I coupled at the output of the preceding schematic a capacitor of 2 picofarads. And you can see it here with that black top. But I also found that you can use a 33 picofarad capacitor. That's also good. Shift back to the first circuit for a while. So here we have that 2 picofarad capacitor or the 33 picofarad capacitor to the gate of the field effect transistor. So this video is of today talking about the my experiences when I made a second amplifier stage, and that second amplifier stage is here, made with an NPN transistor. Here is the first NPN transistor amplifier stage, and here's the second one. And my idea was that I could get more amplification with a second stage, but that did not work. More information in the earlier video. Finally, this circuit. Here it's all completed, how it works, how I made it, with all the, say, proper connections, etc., etc. They were also in the early videos, by the way, anyway. Been over somewhat. First transistor, all these four ceramic filters, they are here. These yellow boxes. The field effect transistor, the coupling capacitor to the first NPN transistor stage, and the extra NPN transistor stage that to a certain extent did not work the way I wanted it. I wanted more amplification, say an output voltage of approximately 3 volts or so, and I'm not completely sure that I get that voltage anyway. I show the schematic as it is, and the reason is that after this we get a germanium detection diode that has to detect the AM radio signal of the long wave radio receiver, and perhaps this second stage can help to push that AM radio detector diode, germanium diode, with a barrier voltage in the range of 0.2 up to 0.5 volts, make it, say, in a certain way, a better detector by giving it somewhat more forward voltage. And there's a lot of information on the World Wide Web about that issue, and also in many of my videos. Anyway, here that IF amplifier again, 455 kilocycles, pan over somewhat to see it was made with brass pins on a well varnished wooden soft triplex board. That's the way I make my circuits. I sent in here via 56 picofarad capacitor the 455 signal out of this generator. Input level is on 10 mil on the 10 millivolt scale, and it's now on 1, so the input to the IF amplifier is approximately 10 millivolts. Let's see what happens when we change the resonance frequency. Gonna do that now by changing the frequency of the generator. Let's look at the scope, and we can of course at the same time look at the output level. Change it somewhat. Perhaps you can see the change in the frequency. Of course, when it doesn't resonate, the counter on my scope also doesn't work. But anyway, back to a lower frequency, no resonance, high resonance here, peak resonance here, on 4, 5, 3 kilocycles. The filter was originally made for 4, 5, 5 kilocycles, but anyway, no problem with that. There's always damping. So when you have a filter here, so here there is a kind of series capacitor over the filter. Here there is capacitance and resistance over the filter that drops the frequency of such a 4, 5, 5 kilocycle filter somewhat down. No problem with that. I hear a lot of beeps, don't know where they come from. Anyway, here is the meter connected to the output, and it reads 2 volts. That is in a certain way strange, because on my other meter that I used earlier, I had an output of 1 volt. And the problem with all these meters is that they are not equipped. They are kind of hobby meters for consumers. They are not equipped to, say, give a reliable measurement of such a high frequency on 4, 5, 5 kilocycles. Anyway, it works. It gives a kind of indication. And the strange thing is also, when you move your finger over the screen, you give the meter a kind of static charge that makes the pointer move. By the way, no bad things about these analog meters. They are in fact the best meters that can be used in this case. And perhaps I have to make a millivolt meter that really gives out proper indication about the output voltage on this frequency, 4, 5, 5 kilocycles. Anyway, let's see what happens when we change the resonance frequency of the filter. We'll do that now. And that's a very good thing. The output level falls back. Here is the top of the resonance, and that is confirmed here with the oscilloscope, the top of the resonance. I move now the generator alongside 4, 5, 5 kilocycles in that band. So this meter surely gives a good or a certain indication. Is it really 2 volts, the output level? I really don't know. And in a certain way, that's also not very important. Strange to say, anyway, when you make such a radio, it's very important that you know where the resonance is and that there is a certain output level at the end of your IF amplifier. Anyway, back to the circuit. Only thing that is important now to tell is that the extra stage here doesn't work. When you I have now tapped out the signal here that you see on the scope via a 100 nanofarad capacitor to the scope and to the meter. So this part of the circuit is now not in use. And this is the only part of the circuit that is in use at the moment. That could be important. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope it was a little bit helpful. Always interested in comments and always interested in your own radio experiments. Upload them to your YouTube channel. Give links. Everyone can learn from that. Everyone can also learn from all the, say, fails when making radio circuits, etc., etc. Most important thing is that electronics is fun. And it is a very, very interesting hobby. So let's finally look at this beautiful sine wave, more or less in the dark. Say, that's joy. Pure physics.